Hello, Monosaurus. Today I'm going to help you to understand why the phytonutrients in fruit isn't actually worth the fructose you're consuming. And if you stick around till the end of the video, I've got a fact that's going to absolutely blow your mind. If you're meeting me for the first time, my name's Violet Rivera, and the reason I make these videos is because when mental health and physical health are working well together, that's how we have that overall sense of well-being. If this is something that you're working on, subscribe because I make new videos every week. Fructose is the sugar that you find in fruit. And the reason that it's encouraged is because when you eat it, you don't have the blood sugar spike that you have when you eat sucrose, the other sugar that's in fruit and other things, and all the other sugars that we have. So it's seen as harmless. But in actuality, there's a huge problem with fructose that we've been ignoring that is actually really important. Recently, I was watching a video by Dr. Barry. And he was going through all the different reasons that fructose is dangerous for us, naming all the ones that I already knew. But he said this one particular thing. He said,
You know that glucose, if you eat too much glucose or raise your blood sugar, it actually causes glycation of your cells and tissues. This is what the test, hemoglobin A1C, that's what it actually measures. The problem is that fructose, even though your body's cells can't use it for energy, it actually glycates the cells and tissues in your body 7 times greater than glucose. And so eating a high fructose diet or drinking lots of glucose, you're going to cause a huge increase in the production of advanced glycation end products.
when you hear something like that, it actually does not sound like fructose is harmless. And you know what? I understand that the damage is happening slowly, slowly over time. It takes years for that glycation problem to happen and impact us. However, I already learned from Dr. Fung that they did experiments where they fed people stuff that had high fructose corn syrup in it, and the damage to the liver didn't take years. The damage, so the fatty liver, so the weight of the liver was already going up after just a few months. So we have this misperception that we need to wait for the damage to be fatal before we call it damage. But if my liver is gaining weight as soon as I start drinking things that have high fructose corn syrup in them, or eating things that have high fructose corn syrup in them, or eating large quantities of fruit, if my liver is already gaining weight just by the sheer process of doing that, then doesn't that mean that damage is already being caused? We don't need to wait for a situation to be dire before we decide to take action. It's very interesting because today we know that smoking causes damage. And we inform our young people and we try our best to make sure our young people do not touch cigarettes ever in their life because smoking causes damage. Even though it takes years for the damage to become fatal, the damage is starting from the day you start smoking. Fructose is the same thing. The damage is starting from the day that you allow yourself to eat or drink or consume anything that has fructose in it. This makes me question why, on a very global level, why do we fight this information? This idea we have that fruit is healthy. And what's it based on? Who decides what's healthy? Is it a doctor? Is it a nutritionist? Is it a scientist? Or is it your body and the reaction your body has to the things you ingest? If I eat sugar, fructose in this particular case is what we're talking about. If I eat fructose and my liver becomes fatty, becomes inflamed, is that not saying that fructose isn't healthy? So I decided to do some digging to figure out when was the first time that we knew that fructose was related to fatty liver. And there was a doctor, Samuel Zelman, and he noticed one of his clients drinking a lot of soda and having fatty liver, and started to do some research. And after about a year, concluded that fatty liver and fructose were related. That connection happened back in 1952. We are 2021. That's 69 years ago, guys. And yet, still today, we're acting like if we don't know. Even though, when you look up non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, one of the things they say is excessive amounts of fructose. So it's not that doctors don't know. It's not the scientists don't know. It's that the mass population doesn't know. Because the mass population doesn't even know that they actually have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Because the mass population does not understand why their midsection protrudes. The mass population doesn't understand that this protruding stomach is a sign of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. The majority of us does not understand that if we are overweight, chances are very high we also have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. We don't know that when we have diabetes, chances are we have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And that connection between diabetes and fatty liver was made back in the 1700s. Fructose is damaging to our body. And we make it worse by juicing so that we can eat or drink even more of the fruit that's causing our liver damage. And it's very damaging to the body because it's mostly metabolized by the liver because the body cells, for the most part, cannot use it. It's not because it doesn't raise our blood sugar levels that it's harmless. What it actually means is that it's worse for our body because the rest of our body isn't using it because small amounts mean huge impact to our liver. It's so important for us to understand this piece of information because that's a huge cause of fatty liver disease. If you found this video informative and helpful, share it because there are people out there that need this information. There are videos on the screen right here that are going to help you to improve your health. Wellness Warriors, I am always happy that you come back, and everybody who's new, welcome. I want to thank you for watching Mind Blowing Health and Wellness with Violet, and I really can't wait to talk to you guys again next week.